How are you? I'm good. Now, of course, here we go again. I haven't done videos in a week. There was fall break last week, so of course, when my child is in here, everything gets paused, and here we go again. So, you know, thinking about, I have a list. I don't know if I have said this before, but I have a list of a lot of topics, you know, all related to special needs. And it's like a long, long list. But, you know, just trying to decide what shall I talk to about today. And then I always tend to talk about things that happened recently because, you know, I just have them fresh in my mind, and because I don't have anything scripted, so I just sit in here, just think about what I'm going to talk about, and I just go. I'm not reading anything, so maybe what I'm saying after, then I was like, oh, I probably could have said something different. But that's what it is. It's because it's exactly how I want the videos to be, you know, unscripted, unedited, it's raw. I just sit in here, I talk, and there you go. So it goes related to two topics, what I'm going to talk about. And one, it's about discrimination, and the other one, it's about inclusion. Because yes, both go together because they're opposites. And you know, in day-to-day life, I feel that all of us at some point in our life, we will be faced to make a decision. And either you go one or the other one. I'm not in here to judge anyone. I think that all of us know what is right and what is wrong. And it's up to you to do whatever you want to do. If that makes you happy and to be a better person, go for it. But within the special needs world, this is something that it always almost hit both at the same time. Because, you know, more often than we would like, you know, children, youth, adults, you know, within the special needs community, which is, again, it's a big community worldwide. So I don't think that it's a minority at all, because once you are exposed to the special needs world and you go to a doctor's office, so for example, to a neurologist, there's thousands of people in there. And I feel that once you start getting into things, and you realize that there's just a lot of people. But anyway, so I feel that, you know, we always face discrimination in one way or another, from access to places, from, you know, being included to everything. And it goes from the basic, you know. So for example, at school. Okay, let's just something pretty quick and easy. Your children are at school and they're doing their, you know, day-to-day life, but it's not that it's a bad thing. It's just that I feel that, and maybe I'm coming up with these excuses all the time, but I feel that people that have never been faced, you know, with something different to them, and it can mean anything, okay? So take what I'm talking about into anything in life, not only in the special needs world. But I feel that those that have never been exposed to different things, they are always a little bit more, you know, are going to be willing to push back a little bit because they have not grown up with different things. And of course, I'm not talking about the material things. I'm just talking about, you know, so let me give you an example. When I was growing up, I had, you know, exposed of everything. So for example, I watch cartoons from different parts of the world. I watch anime, you know, in early 80s, because that was a big thing. Everything was imported. Everything that was bought in my house, it was imported. And everything that I watch, you know, I watch, you know, even TV shows from Korea, Japan, things in French, and I don't know, that's just to give you an idea, that's how I grew up. So, of course, I grew up being exposed to so many things that being different has always kind of been okay to me. But at the same time, the special needs world was totally unknown to me. It's one of those things that maybe you saw something, and usually it was used more like Down syndrome, because I think that that was something that everyone recognized right away without knowing that special needs world is, it's everything. and so much more at the same time. And, you know, growing up, I didn't have classmates with, you know, physical mobility, you know, issues or cognitive delays or even Down syndrome. Honestly, there was probably none of that in my entire school. But we have to remember that, you know, times have changed. And I think that in many parts of the world, there were schools that were for, you know, special education, and children with special needs, all of them were to these, you know, specially developed schools. So in the mainstream classrooms, everyone seems to be the same, which I get that that's how it was back then, but things have changed so much that now, which I love, because many places of, you know, of the world, law has been created to say these children are part of our community. They have to be part of the school system. They have to be part of society, in work, in, you know, going to college and everything. So I think that for me, that's great, because we are going to the right place and we still have a lot of work to do. But at the same time, you know, for everyone who were not exposed to the special needs community, because they were not exposed to that, that's why sometimes it's harder for them to understand things. And that's when I say that I make excuses. Because I understand that, you know, I totally get it. You know, when we started our special needs journey, everything was new to us, and because we were never exposed to that, that just seems like maybe that happened to other people, or there was just so many things that honestly we had no idea. And now I feel horrible, because now, you know, for example, if I'm at the supermarket and there's a child screaming, I'm not thinking that that child probably is having a tantrum. My first thought is that, well, maybe that child may have autism. So now I just think that how myself 20 years ago, you know, I don't know, we will go on vacation in the airplane and there will be, you know, a child screaming or crying, and we all go, it's like, ugh, you know, here we go, that child and the baby. And now I'm mortified, because I know what that parent is going through, maybe if they have special needs or not, but because now I'm on the other side, I totally get it. So anyway, so discrimination in inclusion goes hand in hand, and I feel that we can easily discriminate things that we don't know or things that maybe we're not comfortable with. In inclusion, it's letting go of all that. It's not caring about differences. It's not caring about what makes us, you know, different. It's not caring about how you look. It's not caring about what you have and you don't have. It's not caring about the decisions you make in life. And for me, I'm all about inclusion, because I feel that the only thing that I can do better, not only for me, for my family, for my son, for society in general, is to do that. And when somebody, you know, will say something in a, not only, you know, discriminatory or derogatory way towards me, I'm like, you know what? I have been through so much that honestly, I don't care. If that makes you happy at that moment, trying to make me feel that way, good for you. But honestly, for me, I'm like, ooh, couldn't care less. Because I have lived so much more than that. And at the same time, I would never let, you know, it's not that it's a negative. I'm talking about the derogatory or discriminatory comment to change me, because I'm still all about inclusion, and I wouldn't want any of that to affect me. Because the moment that we start making that change us, that's when we're making the wrong decision for us. Because everyone is entitled to make the right decision for themselves. Well, we can do too. So if you live by an inclusive way, you know, and I'm talking about be kind to other people who may look different than you, who may speak another language than you, who may have more or less knowledge than you, you can see that this is such a beautiful world. And I always tell everyone, you know, when we go through hard times in life, but I'm talking about like major things. So for example, a car accident, you know, that your house is in fire, you know, catastrophes, you know, things are totally out of your proportion. If somebody can go and help you, you're not going to care about their skin color, what language they have. You're not going to care if they have mobility problems. You're not going to care if, you know, they have a specific genetic condition. If they're there to help you, I guarantee you that you're going to be happy and thankful to heaven that somebody was there to give you a hand. So that's what, you know, I wanted to talk about today, because, you know, of course, something that happened recently. But to me, I'm like, you know, I feel that I'm like easy target for everything and anything, you know, for my accent, the way that I live, because of my child's condition. So I do have a pretty good thick skin, way thicker than what my people may think of, because I have gone through so much already that at this stage of my life, I'm like, you know what? I don't care if that makes you happy. Maybe when I was 20, probably things could have affected me, but you know, I'm not 20 anymore and I have my priorities in place and I know what is important to me, and it's just to be inclusive to everyone. And that's exactly why, you know, if I spoke more than two languages, I would be doing videos in every language that I know, to make you feel welcome, to make you feel included in this, because all of us are part of this. All of us are part of the world and society. So you do have a place in this. And if you ever feel discriminated in any way, by the way that you live your life, by your decisions, by who you are, by your special needs, from where you come from or for where you go, know that I understand and I'm not alone. There's a lot of people that understand, and you're not alone, and you're loved, and you are important as I am, as you, and as everyone. So just try to live your life as the most inclusive as you can, and try to expose yourself to different things. And do the same for your children if you have children. If in your child's classroom you know that there is a special needs child, invite them to your birthday party. Maybe, honestly, they may not go, but invite them, because everyone wants that. Won't you want that for your child? Wouldn't you want that if your child is different, to be included in everything at school, other parties, within society? I think you do. So that's kind of like the same message, because we never know when our life can change. And you want that all the good and the love that you have given to the world to come back to you. So that's it for today. Well, take care. Bye.